All right, so this is another tarantula unboxing. These are the tarantulas I'm getting. Darlinghi, Vengus, Cobalts. I believe that they gave me a free Cobalt. I got a Mexican Red Romp. So how to usually do it, they have a box inside of a box, like so. So this box, just put it down there. Keep packed it cold. Now, I'm doing it in my room with this towel. Now, I'm gonna tell you guys a little trick. If you guys ever get tarantulas, know that they have little prongs on the bottom of their feet. So if you have a towel which has a lot of woven points, those prongs will actually get stuck in the fabrics and then they won't be able to move that fast. So this is basically for DOA or dead on arrival. So they would actually send out a new one. But it has to be accepted on first delivery, and it was. So I got a sexing kit because I do have a lot of slings. Okay. Now here comes the exciting part. Alright, so this one, they actually messed up on, packaging. So right now, as I was undoing it, the tarantula was getting ready to come out. This is the Darlinghi. So watch and see how it won't actually get stuck, but it will start moving extremely slow for what it is. Damn it. I'm sorry. Catch cup. Oh, perfect. So, I'm gonna use this as a catch cup. There we go. Just like that. That's how you guys are supposed to do it. And boom, that's one down. And I mean, these cups are a little bit these are actually used. But it's in there, trust me. If it wasn't, I wouldn't even keep going with this. Let's see. Next one. So I forgot what the common name for this one is. But this big one over here is for the Mexican Red one. That one I'm actually... Oh, please, no. Come on. Oh, you faker. Now, I actually like to use the lids that they originally give. If you guys can see it. But yeah, I like to use the lids that they originally give because it does have their names on them. So yeah, and let me prepare two more. This is a very interesting hobby too. There's nothing in here. This is for the red rump because I'm expecting that one to be big. My bad. I'm just trying to figure out because I don't want to, you know, end up getting the red rump. Just in case. Because since that one is, can be a bit bolty, I don't want to, you know, risk it. Oh, so this one's actually one of the actually small ones. So let's go ahead and get this guy. Is this live? Oh yeah, he is. Okay. My bad. I don't like it when they touch me. That's like the one thing I don't like. I don't like holding them. So he's in there. You're not even supposed to hold. Technically, you're not supposed to. These animals are not meant to be held. Some people still do. And sorry, I'm actually not giving you guys the common name.
Yeah.
But I'll make another video on the updates to tell you guys what their common names are. And here's this one. Okay. And come on. No, you don't. All right. I have an OBT sling, so just by habit, whenever I see it start bolting, I just don't touch it until it stops. I'm going to say, whoa, do I even have enough ready? Okay. So, here's another set. Okay. Here's a species name. Oh, shoot. I thought it was going to run out on me. He did a little bit of webbing up while he was in there. That's good. Oh. I believe this one is my chestnut that I actually bought. I might be wrong. I forget stuff a lot. So here it is right there. I'm not sure if you can see it.
Okay.
Come on. I might have to put it in a different cup. Come on, please. I don't have anything else ready. Alright, fine. And this is why I have a whole bunch of supplies that's always usable. I have like a whole bunch of these deadly cups because I often get a lot of slings. That's going in there. He's still in there, but unfortunately we don't have a lid that will actually secure. And that's a big no-no in this house. It'll be all right in here until I can get some substrate in this cup right here. What's wrong with you? You should never touch it. You over there scaring me.
Look at.
There we go. You should never even touch it. Oh my God! Don't ever scare me. I have these to get rid of my arachnophobia. You making me get it again?
It was trying to go in my hand.
You got me sweating. I just got off work and I'm already sweating. I'm in AC.
It was trying to get into my hand.
All right. Let me just pluck coconut fiber right back in there. And so, with this, just, okay. Just like that. Scaredy cat.
That one's quick. I'm sweating. Oh my
God. You got me sweating.
Now I'm the one who's doing all it. Boy.
Alright. And here's the species name. Oh, this one's not looking too good. Damn. We got a DOA. Dead on arrival.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Aww. Put the cover back on.
What are you scared of?
I don't trust it. So you got to turn that one.
They will actually send me out another one. I guess the red one really wasn't that big.
You gonna put it in that one or?
No. Because that the red one would be too small for that one. It would stress it out. It might.
Two.
Wait, were these the? Oh, these were the two cobalt blues. Very colorful tarantula. It's a shame.
So they're both dead.
Yep, both gone. I would have to get in contact with them extremely soon to get some replacements. And in the meantime, I'm actually going to put a lid back on, excuse me, this enclosure here to help keep the moisture in. Because they have 2-day shipping, so I should be getting another one.
So two died.
Within 2 days.
Close that lid, please. So they didn't make it.
It's alright.
But these motherfuckers sure did.
You know this is going on YouTube, right? And Instagram.
These motherfuckers, they was fighting for their life. But these two,
All right, you guys.
They sleeping forever.
You ain't right for that.
Shake my head.
You ain't right. All right, you guys. Have a good day.